And up we go. Come on, come on.
Yeah.
And stand.
It is impossible to appreciate this physical therapy session.
Straighten up now.
I just have that athlete's mentality, you know. No pain, no gain.
That's rock and roll.
The magnitude of seeing Kim Sellers stand.
Hold that thing. All right.
Unless you understand her struggle with advanced multiple sclerosis and her journey with an experimental stem cell treatment that began in January 2014.
We'll bring you back in a few and get you all settled and everything. Sound great?
One of the first patients in a clinical trial at the Ohio Stem Cell Treatment Center in Beechwood, part of the National Cell Surgical Network. Just showing up took courage.
I thought of my kids first. I thought of my parents. I thought about all the people that rely on me.
Kim Sellers here for Tony Marshall.
From 2001 to 2009, the disease slowly and publicly deteriorated this vibrant mom and radio personality's motor skills.
You know, just not knowing. It's just nerve-wracking.
The research is part of the FDA's national data bank and registered with the agency, but not yet FDA approved.
We are very honest about the fact that we cannot promise results.
Doctors Mark Foyetti and Michael Kellis co-founded the center and lead a team of skilled surgeons performing the procedure, which begins with liposuction.
But there's something extraordinarily good at this point about body fat.
The highly regenerative substance is extremely rich in stem cells and harvested in a sort of biological super soup called stromal vascular fraction, or SVF.
There are mast cells, T cells, B cells, macrophages. It is a wonderful mixture of cells that are used here.
Helping the body heal itself in a number of disorders, from autoimmune to neurology, urology, and orthopedics.
The most successful treatments have been in orthopedics, especially in the knee region.
All right, we're ready, man.
Last November, former Cleveland Browns wide receiver Joe Juravicius had his knee treated.
If I had one goal, to be honest with you, athletically, it isn't to go back on a football field. It's to dunk a basketball one more time in my life.
Dr. Foyetti says the imposing athlete isn't there yet, but almost.
I'm not certain he's dunking a basketball, but last I heard, he was hanging from the rim, which is pretty impressive.
Out of about 2,000 patients so far, Dr. Foyetti says 20% have seen no changes. However, 80% have seen improvements ranging from minor to miraculous.
The more I exercise, I'm telling you, the better I feel.
Kim's results have been somewhat stunning. Doctors say the MS stopped progressing and seems to be in reverse.
After the first round of treatments, she actually like squeezed my hand for the first time, which is kind of cool. I mean, she'd never done that before. No, you owe me four. No, you owe me four. Come on.
Physical therapist Javier Pacheco says other symptoms are also noticeably better.
Good.
Like the rigid spasticity. Although when the muscles relaxed, the real work began.
Kind of retraining my body to do the things that it once could do, and something as simple as walking.
She says there have been many ups and downs.
It's a work in progress, you know. Every day is a challenge.
So the self-proclaimed gym rat also employs personal trainer Joe Keough.
Her mental attitude's gotten so much better. She's an inspiration, there's just no doubt.
Even recently, when her contract wasn't renewed at WZAK after more than two decades DJing.
But I am not retiring. So.
Although there were a few tears, Kim's decided to see the situation as a new opportunity.
As I go into 2016, is my year to really fight and take this whole thing to another level.
Continuing to be a voice and source of strength for everyone out there battling a difficult time or disease.
So long. I just hope that my story allows them to continue on.
In Cleveland, Suzanne Stratford, Fox 8 News.